We stand as we are able. Born is the King of Israel. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, you have made this most holy night to shine with the brightness of the true light, Jesus Christ our Lord. Grant that as we have known on earth the mysteries of that light, we may also come to the fullness of his joys in heaven, through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated, and at this time I invite the children to come forward for the children's message. Let's see, we got everybody? Almost everybody? Kind of everybody. Well, hi there. Good evening. Good to see you guys all here today. Guess what we're not doing today? That's a good answer. We are not lighting the candles because look around you. Look at all these lights. Look at all these candles lit. You know, these last couple weeks, you know, we had the acolyte come forward and we were lighting a blue candle and singing Light One Candle to Watch for Messiah. But you know what? You know what? You know what? Thank you. You know what? We don't have to do that anymore. Because tonight, Christmas Eve, we celebrate Jesus is here with us. I'm glad you know that. But you know what? There's a lot of people out there that don't know that or may have forgotten that. And it's always a challenge for us to let people know, to always let people know that Jesus is with us every day and that God is always doing something beyond our imagination. Who would have thought many years ago that when God sent his only son to us, he was going to come as a baby. Born in a stable, in a place far, far away that nobody would have ever guessed. And if you want to see what that looks like,
I know what it is, a manger scene.
That's right, it's a manger scene. You know what? Come on up. Take a look over here. You see this right here? This is a manger scene. This is a manger scene. And it's in this way that Jesus came for us. Now, this is a pretty good-sized manger scene. This is a pretty good-sized manger scene.
I have my own manger scene.
A lot of people do. They got them of all sizes and in all kinds of materials and stuff like that. But if you want to see a really big manger scene after church, not during church, after church, take a look outside. And take a look at who's now laying in the manger. He hasn't been there for the last month or so.
I know who it is.
But he's there tonight. That's right. It's Jesus. So let's all come on over here and let's say a prayer. Go that way towards the middle of the aisle there. You don't have to sit down, but thank you anyway. What's that? You said you want prayers for Christmas? Well, have I got a Christmas prayer for you? And you know what? We're going to pray, and the congregation's going to help us join in. So let's pray together.
I ordered a snowboard for Christmas.
Awesome. Let's say a prayer. Congregation, feel free to join in. Dear Jesus.
Dear Jesus.
Thank you so much. For coming all those years ago to save us all from the power of sin and for making us closer to God. Amen. Okay, now I have something I'm going to give each of you, and I'm going to give you two of them. Because One is for you, and I want you to give one to someone else. That way, they can see what you're talking about when you're telling them all about Jesus and how Jesus came a long time ago. Great job, guys. You can if you want. Okay. Okay. Tell you what, you know what we got to do now? Now that we've had a prayer? I don't know who's coming up to read, but we're going to hear the story of Jesus' birth tonight. And so when you guys, if you guys go back and take your seats, you guys get to hear all the stories about Jesus' birth. Thanks for coming up, guys. No, don't go to sleep. You can't go to sleep yet. You hear that? You can't go to sleep yet.
The first lesson is from Isaiah chapter 9, verses 2 through 7. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwell in the land of deep darkness, on them a light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, and they are glad when they divide the spoil. For the yoke of his burden and the staff for his shoulder, the rod of his oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For every boot of the tramping warrior in battle tumult and every garment rolled in blood will be burned as fuel for the fire. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and of peace, there will be no end. On the throne of David and over his kingdom, to establish it and to uphold it with justice and with righteousness, from this time forth and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The psalm is Psalm 96, found on page 261 in your hymnal, and we'll sing it responsibly.
Declare his glory.
The second lesson comes to us from Titus chapter 2, beginning with verse 11. St. Paul writes, "For the grace of God has appeared, bringing salvation for all the people, training us to renounce ungodliness and worldly passions, and to live self-controlled, upright, and godly lives in the present age, waiting for our blessed hope, the appearing of the glory of our great God and Savior, Christ Jesus, who gave himself for us to redeem us from all unlawfulness, and to purify for himself a people for his own possession, who are zealous for good works. Declare these things, exhort and rebuke with all authority. Let no one disregard you. This is the word of the Lord."
Thanks be to God.
The gospel tonight comes to us from Luke, from the Gospel of Luke, the second chapter. This is the traditional Christmas story we all know and love. "In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration when Quirinus was governor of Syria, and all went to be registered, each to his own town. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth, to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to give birth. And she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped them in swaddling cloths, and laid him in the manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. And in the same region there were shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. And they were filled with fear. And the angel said to them, 'Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling cloths and lying in a manger.' And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts praising God and saying, 'Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those with whom he is pleased.' When the angels went away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, 'Let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us.' And they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger. And when they saw it, they made known the saying that had been told them concerning this child. And all who heard it wondered at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured up all these things, pondering them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told to them." This is the gospel of our Lord.
Thank you.
may be seated. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. What can you say? I'm actually at a loss for words here. Seriously, what can you say? I mean, what else is there to say? What else is there to say? This is such a beautiful story. I love hearing it again because it never gets old. No matter how old we are or how young we are, it's always a blessing to hear. This is God's story. This is God's story he wrote himself. A story of peace and reconciliation for all who believe. God himself in human form, seeing us eye to eye and saying, peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace is with you. I am divine peace. There is no other, and I am with you. Isn't that reassuring to hear from God? Isn't it good to know that peace does exist? Peace exists because God himself is peace. God is peace. Peace for us, our neighbors, our friends, for everyone. We can all use peace in our lives. The time for peace is now. See, the Christmas story is a story about peace as well as a call for peace. A call for peace that makes us stop, even for a little while, even for a few hours or so, and reflect on both what happened years ago and who was involved. That moment of divine peace breaking through all the world's noise. The time when God came to earth as a baby. When God sent his son to earth as a baby boy. Who else but God could bring peace to the earth in such a beautiful and creative way? This is the traditional story, the traditional Christmas story as told to us by Luke. It tells how and why our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ came to earth. We hear the story. All the rich details. The baby wrapped in bands of cloth. The glorious angels and the terrified shepherds. All the people involved who gathered on one night in Bethlehem for a once-in-a-lifetime once in the universe experience. God fulfilling the prophecies of old which the world refused to see and accept. Prophecies for peace. Prophecies foretelling the Messiah's coming to restore peace and wholeness to all. A divine peace that only God could give all of humanity. It's no coincidence that God came to earth when he did. He came down from heaven at one of the darkest times in all of world history. One of the darkest times when humanity had completely turned its back on God and was at the height of self-indulgence. Things were not good at all 2,000 years ago. The conquering Roman ruler proclaimed himself as God and forced people to worship him. You believe that? a tyrant, a self-proclaimed God who thought he could force peace with strict and unforgiving laws? Enough was enough. Enough was enough, indeed. God chose the time for the ancient prophecies to be fulfilled. Time to refresh people's memories of the good news to come. Time once and for all, for all of heaven and earth to be reconciled for all eternity, once and for all. Time for God to come to earth and meet us where we are and show us firsthand what a gracious, loving God looks like. God's time. When we learn firsthand what true love looks like. You know, he didn't have to come like he did. You know, God's the creator of heaven and earth. He could have done anything he wanted to. He could have sent a flood to wipe out the world's aggressors. But he didn't, because he keeps his promises. Like the promise he made to Noah and his family long ago, that he would never do something like that ever again. God knew there was a better way, a more powerful way, as told through the prophets. A more powerful way, yet so subtle that it could easily be overlooked if one was not willing to observe and listen to what was going on. God called a faithful Mary and an obedient Joseph. God called some lonely shepherd guys over there on the hills who were outside watching their sheep, far away from the rest of society. God came to them too. God came first to those who were willing to listen and share the good news of his son's incarnation, his son becoming human, his son becoming Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. In other words, divinity becoming human and saving us from ourselves by coming to earth, taking on flesh and bones and blood, and truly understanding and relating to us firsthand what we all go through every day. God's love firsthand breaking into the world and showing us a greater good, greater than anything that the world could ever promise, the greatest good of all, which is God's gift of love that will be with us always and teaches us directly about God's grace and power. A gift that is so powerful that only God himself could give it. And while doing so, shattered the boundaries that tried to keep us apart from God. The gift of love that says, I love you so much that I will die a gruesome and painful death just so you can live forever with total, undeserved forgiveness and grace. No strings attached. The gift that is Jesus Christ himself. The Christmas story is an emotional, wonderful story filled with promise and hope. It's a story that is God's testimony to us and everyone about how he does amazing and impossible things. Amazing, impossible, earth-shattering things that at times go completely unnoticed. How the single greatest cosmic event in human history to accomplish everyone's salvation begins with the birth of a baby boy in a manger at a place far away from here. Who would have thought? It's encouragement for all, because every time we read the Christmas story, we feel a sense of renewed hope and peace that often gets overlooked in our world. It is the renewed hope and peace we feel when we look into a newborn baby's eyes whether it's our child or a grandchild or a niece or nephew. You've done that. You've looked into a baby's eyes. You see those big wide eyes looking back at you. And you see that child. And the only thing you're thinking about at that time is all of the possibilities ahead. There's not a single negative thought in your mind because you're thinking about all the possibilities. All those possibilities. A new life. New life. With new and exciting possibilities that God has in store. There's always something new that the Christmas story can teach us. God's incarnation, where he meets us face to face and gifts us with salvation. His holy and divine peace, which only he can give. See, that's the beauty of the Christmas story, is that God is here and working in our lives. Working in ways we may not know. Or ways that we may not see till years later. And we stop and think, oh yeah, oh yeah. God was up to something years ago, because look where I'm at now. It's how God works in those powerful ways that get our attention. Those ways that he works to bring us peace and wholeness as we pray and respond to God as we journey through our lives. With God always keeping his promises, always following through on his promises, and walking with us every step of the way. His peace and wholeness are for all. What else can you say? What else can you say? For unto you and me and us and the world is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. Grace and peace from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
In Jesus' name, amen. We now stand as we are able for our hymn of the day. God has made us his people through our baptism since Christ's life, death, and resurrection. In doing so, we confess together the words of the Nicene Creed found on page 84 of our hymnals. We confess together, we believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. As we worship the newborn Son of God, let us also pray that he may bring healing, salvation, and peace to the church, the world, and all its people. Lord Jesus Christ, the church throughout the world rejoices in your birth among us and adores you for your great mercy and loving kindness. Make the church your manger and your throne, and bless it with your dear presence, your great goodness, and your holy love. Through its preaching, teaching, and acts of mercy, draw many to seek your face, to find comfort in your strong saving love, and to receive you, the greatest gift of all, into their hearts and lives. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord God, bless our congregation and its ministries. Keep us close to your side. Give us joyful souls, eager to praise and proclaim your precious name. Give us listening ears and watchful eyes, so that we may discern your presence in the unexpected places of our lives. Give us faithful hearts and tireless hands and feet, so we may hurry to worship you and to share your great love with those who need it the most. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord God, Prince of Peace, hush the bitter taunts and break the bitter spears of hatred and persecution among your servants. Bestow your peace in their hearts, so that their suffering for the sake of your name may be turned to great joy, and their tormentors may be transformed into confessors of your undeserved mercy. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Merciful Father, bless all the dear children who most need your tender care. Kindle faith in their hearts and keep them safe from every danger. And give childlike and humble faith to everyone who doubts your existence or despairs of your forgiveness, and give them peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord God, Heavenly Father, you are the King of all nations. Conform the rulers of this world to your glorious and gentle rule. Teach them to do your will, love justice and mercy, to walk humbly with you, and to be a blessing to the people entrusted to their care. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, on this night of grace, peace, and love, we pray for the sinful world. Let your holy angels shield, strengthen, and direct the words and actions of all in our military, all our first responders, and anyone whose work is difficult and dangerous. Bring respect and kindness wherever discord and misunderstanding occur, and bestow the blessings of your peace upon us all. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
O Son of Righteousness, arise with healing in your wings and bestow the glorious light of your salvation upon all who sit in the darkness of suffering and the shadow of death. Restore them to life and hope. Encourage all who care for them and the great news of your birth among us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus, your name says it all. You have come to save us from every evil, from our sins, and from death itself. We commend into your sure care all our beloved dead, especially those we remember before you now. Deal mercifully with tears and sorrows of those whose grief is raw and deep. Stay near us, Lord Jesus, and love us and guide us throughout our lives. Bless us with your love so we may be a blessing to others. And bring all your dear children to heaven to live with you forever in the holy light of your love, which you have shared eternally with your Father and the Holy Spirit. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord God, we pray for all those who are away from home. We pray for all those who are still traveling in this busy season through inclement weather. Lord God, we pray for all those who are away from their families right now, all those who are sick. Lord God, we especially lift up to you Sherry Reitzel, our sister in Christ here at St. James. Lord God, be with her and the medical staff at Catawba Valley as we all seek through prayer your wisdom and your healing hands as we all minister to our sister Sherry. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Into your hands, merciful Father, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's share God's peace together.
Come on.
Let us pray. Merciful Father, we offer with joy and thanksgiving what you have first given us, ourselves, our time, and our possessions, signs of your gracious love. Receive them for the sake of him who offered himself for us, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is indeed right and salutary that we should, at all times and in all places, offer thanks and praise to you, O Lord, Holy Father, through Christ our Lord. In the wonder and mystery of the Word made flesh, you have opened the eyes of faith to a new and radiant vision of your glory, that beholding that God made visible, we may be drawn to the love of God, whom we cannot see. And so with the church on earth and the host of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. You are indeed holy, almighty and merciful God. You are most holy and great is the majesty of your glory. You so love the world that you gave your only Son, that whoever believes in him may not perish but have eternal life. Having come into the world, he fulfilled for us your holy will and accomplished our salvation. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks. He broke it and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And again after supper, he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." For as often as we eat of this bread and drink from this cup, we proclaim the Lord's life, death, and resurrection until he comes again. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. You may be seated. We stand. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, you gave your Son both as a sacrifice for sin and a model of the godly life. Enable us to receive him always with thanksgiving and to conform our lives to his through the same Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, you made this holy night shine with the brightness of the true light. Grant that here on earth, we may walk in the light of Jesus' presence, and in the last day, wake to the brightness of his glory. Through your only Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And now may the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you his peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Christ is born today. Go and share the good news.